Expect the best used car deals guaranteed. Visit arnoldclark.com.
Welcome to Peter and Ruffy's Football Show. It's Friday. I'm Peter Martin. Thank you very much for joining us. Alan Ruff and Barry Ferguson, as ever, with us here in the studio with lots to look forward to. A full card of football in the Scottish Premiership. Lots to talk about, and of course, the first port of call is Celtic and Neil Lennon. He certainly had all guns loaded today, and first of all, he set his sights on the SFA.
Scott Brown doesn't have to reproach himself for anything. Obviously, the club, myself, the players will defend Scott vigorously on any charges that he's been cited for, because we feel he's done absolutely nothing wrong, if very little. I think it's a massive deflection. All this noise this week about Scott, I think our players handled the game brilliantly and some of the opposition players did not. I think it's just been concocted because of media pressure or pressure from elsewhere.
Well, there you are. It's been concocted by media pressure in some quarters or from elsewhere. Scott Brown, cited for his celebrations towards the Rangers supporters. Do you think he's got a case to answer for, Ruffy?
Well, we've already discussed it. We don't mind, you know, the people celebrating at the end of the game, as long as you do it in the right manner. I think he's been taken up not for the celebration, but for a couple of the gestures he made. I think that's what he'll be pulled up on, if he's made any gestures towards the Rangers supporters, and they'll have to decide if he did or if he didn't.
Yeah, I think personally it sets a dangerous precedent if we're now in a situation where you're looking at Scott Brown and saying if he celebrates in front of opposition fans, then, you know, week in, week out, we're going to have to go over it with a fine-tooth comb.
Yep, I think that's going to be the case if something happens with Scott Brown. I've had my say on it. I think it was a bit silly. Listen, he's obviously happy. He's captained his team to a victory. He's got every right to celebrate. just celebrate with your own people, your own fans, and your teammates. But listen, if something happens in the next few games, players are going to think twice about celebrating, yeah, even when they're not with their own fans.
Yeah, with every team in the Premiership.
Yep, every single team. these players are going to have second thoughts about celebrating.
Yeah. He then set his sights, Neil Lennon, on Steven Gerrard.
It's reminiscent of the one that myself and Ali had a bit of a word. And that's all it was, a few words exchanged, where, again, the opposition had three men sent off, yet it was called the shame game. So it's very reminiscent for me that they have had three players actually banned, and we've had none, yet and all. Scott Brown's getting dragged into this for whatever reason, I don't know. The only rational thing Stephen said this week, from what I've seen, is that his team played the best team in the country on Sunday. Apart from that, I disagree with probably 90% of what he's spoken about since the game on Sunday.
Well, managers are often guilty of this, Ruffy, and I'm not just talking about Celtic or Rangers managers. Neil Lennon's suggesting that Steven Gerrard's just trying to deflect away from, first of all, the indiscipline, then over and above that, the fact they lost the game. You know, managers often try and paint pictures and take your eye off the ball of what has happened. I mean, in midweek when I was listening to Steven Gerrard talking about defending Ryan Kent, I thought, this is just a lot of nonsense. He punched him. End of story. He's not going to get off with that.
Yeah, and it didn't matter whether Steven Gerrard knew him when he was 8 or 9 or 10, and he didn't have a bad bone in his body. The facts were there for everybody to see. The boy just lost it for a minute, and he was guilty, and he got found guilty. Mm. And I think that's the point Neil's trying to make there. I don't think I remember seeing any Celtic player showing any aggression at all. It was all a reaction to what the Rangers players were doing. But again, Barry's been there. You're in the face. No, you've just been beaten by your biggest rivals. You know, some people react differently from others, and then you've just got to, you know, try and stop it all. But as Barry said, I don't remember anybody being actually hit by a blow in any of these skirmishes. It is handbags, you know, but the powers that be don't want to see that kind of thing, because this game is our biggest game in the season. Yeah. So they don't want to see anybody else seeing things like that out, because it takes it away for the football. We haven't spoken about the football. We've talked about all the fights. And at the end of the day, we want to promote in our game, because there are good football games getting played.
Yeah, with all due respect to Celtic against Rangers, or Rangers against Celtic, is famous the world over. It's famous the world over, not because there's top drawer football in it. I mean, let's be honest about it. I mean, the last time we had half decent top drawer players, he was kicking a ball for Rangers.
Yeah, but I'm sure we'd like to be sitting here, what, 6 days after the game, talking about how good some of the goals were, than talking about red cards and fighting and punching and appealing and,
yeah,
you know.
There'll be a close eye on the Hearts Hibs game now.
Yeah, I'll tell you, I'll go back to that game. Morelos and Kent, you can't defend. They've reacted. They'll know that. They're players. Halliday, listen, I've played in plenty of Old Firm games. I know what it's like after it. Passions are high, and obviously, as I says, it is handbags, Peter. There's a couple of pushes and shoves, and then just go on. But 30 seconds, it's done. But getting into the Hibs and Hearts, you're getting into another feisty encounter. And I've watched plenty of Hearts-Hibs games as well, and they're in each other's faces.
Yeah.
So they've got to be careful, the SFA. I don't understand them at times.
Yeah.
They've got to realise what type of game it is. It's not just about the football. Passions, as I says, run high. Emotions run high. There was nothing really I watched. But as I says, pushing each other. I know Lustig got his shirt ripped, but there was nothing really in it. Let's be honest. There was nobody punched in the face, as Ruffy had mentioned. There was nobody kicked.
Yeah.
Just got on with it.
There's maybe one punched in the face, but that was like, you know,
during the game.
I can't defend.
I was being flippant with it, but at the end of the day, hopefully we'll start to talk about, as you guys mentioned there, the football coming up over the weekend. We'll also look at the post-split fixtures coming up, but as ever, it's games where you might want to have a few quid on. Our head-to-head is getting mightily close now. Here's our reporter Gabriel Antoniazzi looking at the odds for the weekend matches.
This weekend is the final set of fixtures before the split takes place. The tightest part of the table is down the bottom, so keep an eye out for the three-way relegation battle. Let's see some odds. Getting us underway with the early kickoff on Saturday is the Edinburgh Derby. Hibs have not won at Tynecastle since 2013, but are one of the in-form teams in the division. Could they break the bad run? They're 19-10 to do so. Celtic could wrap up their 8th title in a row if they beat Livingston and Rangers lose on Sunday, so I think it could be a big scoreline. Celtic to win -3 is 15-4. Dundee are 2 points adrift at the bottom of the table, so they need every single point they can get their hands on, whereas Aberdeen have been excellent on the road all season. Both teams to score is good value at evens. Hamilton Accies against St Mirren, possibly the biggest game of the season for both sides. I spoke to Brian Rice in the week and he was very confident about this one, so I'm going with his team at 13-8. Kilmarnock are level on points with Aberdeen but will desperately want to finish above them to confirm this is their best season in recent memory. They're a good price to beat St Johnson here, and them to win -1 is 9-4. Finally, on Sunday, Rangers visit Motherwell with no Ryan Kent, Alfredo Morelos or even Steven Gerrard, who are all banned. It could come back to haunt them. A draw is 11-4.
No.
Yeah, there you have it. There's the odds on the games, Ruffy. We're going to talk about them in detail. We'll also be looking at the split fixtures as well, because there's no doubt about it, Ruffy, when we have a look at that after our quick quiz question, you know, there are fans you know, top end, bottom end of the table are going to be unhappy.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. Particularly the teams who are in crucial games, they want to know why their team has got only two home games when their opponents have got three. You know, but usually the powers that be come out and tell us why. You know, sometimes you might get 3-1 year, you might get 3-2 year ago, and that's the way. It's not a biased decision. It's just the way they try to make it equal.
Yep, and Rangers against Celtic will be the second last game of the season. We'll look at the post-split fixtures. We'll also look at the fixtures over this weekend after we give you the winner of the quiz. Well done to Scott Wright. We'll be sending out one of our team t-shirts to you in, hopefully, colours that you like, and you can wear that maybe on one of your nights out if you're going to a club. Well, it's good enough to wear with it, believe me. Let's concentrate on the weekend's fixtures as well. Here's a look at what's on offer. We've already had the odds for it. Hearts, Hibs, 12:30 tomorrow. Celtic, Livingston, Dundee, Aberdeen, Hamilton against St Mirren, Kilmarnock, St Johnstone, and Motherwell against Rangers on the Sunday. We've already discussed the fact that Morelos has had to sit kicking his heels with a four-game suspension. Here's Steven Gerrard's take on the opposition they're facing on Sunday.
We are aware that they have changed the style slightly. That doesn't mean at times that they won't go direct. They're obviously playing with exciting wingers at the moment, inverted, that like to come inside, go outside. They seem to be a bit younger, more energy about them, so they've done very, very well at home. I think it's 5 on the spin. They've maybe won. Obviously, their away form is not as strong at home, but you know we're going to their place, so we expect a good Motherwell team. We expect a reaction from their defeat last night, so we'll have to find a similar level to last night to try and get out of it what we want.
Yeah, I think this has got the makings of a cracker on Sunday, Ruffy.
Yeah, I think Motherwell will make it hard for them. I think all the young boys who have been very, very good at the latter part of the season will go out and want to try and make a name for themselves. But I think with Defoe and Davis back in there, we saw midweek there how influential we were. But I've already said, you know, I can't believe this is the first time for a long time the two of them have started a game. I just can't believe two players of that calibre should have been playing maybe a month ago. I mean, I know they're saying Davis wasn't up to speed, but he was playing with Northern Ireland, so they must have thought he had some level of fitness. So I think these two will be big players, and I think they'll be good enough to beat Motherwell on the day.
Barry?
Yeah, so, listen, Rangers have got to get into the game with confidence, because their performance against Hearts, I know people are going to say Hearts were poor, which they were, but Rangers were good on the night. And for me, you just mentioned them. Davis was back to his best, controlling the game, dictating the game, and obviously Defoe popping up with a goal. So look, Motherwell's, it's always a difficult place to go, but you know it's different now, because see the surface at Fir Park's great now.
Yeah.
So there's no excuse about the surface. So I think they'll go there and it'll be a tough game, but I think they'll win it.
Are you surprised by, I mean, Aberdeen are saying that they're going to try and keep Greg Stewart. Are you surprised he's been linked with a move to Rangers?
I'm not surprised, if I'm being honest. It looks if Rangers aren't going to be able to afford Kent, but I look at Kent, if Stewart's going to come in and replace Kent, they're different players. Kent's blistering pace.
Don't forget Jordan Jones can come in as the replacement for Kent.
Listen, Greg Stewart's a good player. I mean, he had a fantastic 6 months at Kilmarnock. He was a main difference there, but as he... I think the players that Rangers need to bring in need to come straight into the starting 11.
Yeah.
Greg Stewart's a good player, don't get me wrong. Is he going to play week in, week out at Rangers? I'm not sure.
Right, okay. Rangers to win that one. Are you both going for Celtic on the Saturday?
Yes.
Yeah, both going for them. Okay, what about Hearts against Hibs? Craig Levine's already said, you know, we're trying to sanitise football too much, clean it up. Everybody's got to be whiter than white. I've seen some feisty Edinburgh derbies, Ruffy. You've been involved in them.
Yeah, I was involved in one right at Graeme Souness's first game, which turned into everybody getting booked bar me. Just so that
just out of curiosity, I said it could be a feisty Edinburgh derby, and you say, yeah, I've been involved in one. It was Graham Souness's first game when Rangers came calling.
Yeah.
What about an Edinburgh derby, Ruffy? Yeah. I don't know where you got the link.
That one just stuck in my mind because I remember it was so. It was in all the papers, but
that's got nothing really to do with an Edinburgh derby, has it?
Game. No, it doesn't. I don't. Okay. I remember. I know there's feisty Hibs Hearts games, but I don't remember any trouble around the players beating the players.
What?
Well, I've seen.
Are you kidding?
No, not that I played in anyway. I don't remember anybody getting any trouble.
Well, you probably were that demoralised because you lost all 16 of them.
That's what I'm saying. Once you lose, you just go off the park. That's my motto. You know why? I just still can't get my head around anybody who gets beat in a derby game would want to go and start clapping their supporters and everything, get down the tunnel and find out what went wrong.
Yeah, it's a new 21st century thing where they applaud the fans even though they haven't actually been able to live up to their expectations. But I've got a sneaky feeling that Hearts can edge this one.
I think it's going to be a draw.
Yeah.
Draw written all over the top of it for me.
Okay, our reporter Gabriel Antoniazzi looks at this match.
The third Edinburgh derby of the season takes place at 12:30 on Saturday as Hearts host Hibernian, with only 1 point separating the two sides. How are the teams shaping up? Hibs are unbeaten in 7 in the league and have looked solid and improved under new manager Paul Heckingbottom, who has just been named Manager of the Month. However, Hibs have won only one of the past 6 derbies and they've not won at Tynecastle since 2013. Hearts' form is indifferent and they haven't put 3 wins together since last year. They were poor on Wednesday against Rangers, but will have Uche Ikpeazu back in their side on Saturday. He terrorised the Aberdeen defence in last week's victory, so that will give them a boost. The match is often low scoring. Only once since the famous 5-1 2012 Cup final have there been more than 3 goals in a game. Historically, Hearts are the dominant side, with 141 wins to Hibs' 84. The eyes of Scottish football will be on the game, with the focus not only on the pitch, but also on the conduct of the fans after several incidents in recent derbies. For sure, there will be talking points after this one.
You better believe it. I always enjoy the Edinburgh derby, so Barry's gone for a draw. I think Hearts will edge it. What about you, Ruffy?
I'm going for a draw.
You're going for a draw on that one. Okay. Hamilton against St Mirren, the Ackies. There's something that tells me that they're going to escape against St Mirren and Dundee at the bottom now.
For me, this is the biggest game of the weekend. I think it's the most important game. Hamilton will go into this game believing that if they get a win here, that it's safety again. But I think St Mirren have got something to offer. I know they didn't play particularly well, but I just think this is the last ditch saloon for them, and I think they'll win it 2-1.
St Mirren?
Yep.
Yeah.
I'm going to go for Hamilton.
Yeah.
I've seen St Mirren during the week. I wasn't impressed. I know they were missing a few of their starters. But I've just got a feeling that Hamilton will win this game.
Yeah, what about Dundee? You haven't won in 6 now.
I fear for them. I honestly fear for them. A few weeks back, I was still confident that Jim McIntyre would get about it, but the some of the results I've had of late have been, he must be tearing his hair out, so I think Aberdeen will go down there and win pretty easily.
Yeah, as far as Kelly St Johnstone, I think Kelly are going to finish third. Ruffy, you might disagree with me on this.
No, I think they've got their act together again. I think they will win at the weekend. I honestly think that they will. Think that once the split comes, I haven't seen the split yet of where their games are, but if they were to get 3 games at home, I would think they might challenge.
Are they going to win against Johnson?
Yes, I think they will, yeah.
Yep, come on, look for me.
Yep, okay, we're all agreed on that. Let's have a look at the post-split fixtures for the top half of the Premiership, and Hearts against Rangers is one of the first ones on the Saturday with a high noon kickoff there. Kilmarnock Aberdeen kicks off at 3, but Hibs Celtic, that could actually be title celebration day. Sunday the 21st of April, then Celtic at home against Kilmarnock undoubtedly would be, as expected, it all goes according to plan. Celtic would be hoping that somewhere along the line there, if it's not that game, then it might be the home game on the 19th of May, they would receive the trophy against Hearts, unless you guys are going to tell me something different. But there it is, screaming out at you, Barry. 12th of May, Rangers against Celtic, second last game of the season. Is that enough to avoid any madness of title celebrations?
I think it'll be over by then. And Rangers just need to make sure they get something out of the game, as simple as that. I was just interested to see when the game would be. So, looking forward to it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep. It's a long way away, but the build-up's started already with your face.
No, but that's what I would be doing if I'm in the dressing room. Yeah. Any of the guys.
Can't wait.
Yeah, listen, that's what we've got to look forward to.
Yeah, what about the bottom half, Ruffy? Have a look at it now, just briefly. Hamilton Accies have got 3 home games.
Yeah, I think that's going to be massive. I think that, obviously, Jim McIntyre will be hoping that the split comes quicker, you know, because I think he'll believe that they're good enough to take points off of these players. But certainly I think home advantage gives you a wee advantage. But Dundee there have got only 2 games at home. So
yeah, Dundee have got... it's going to be hard for them. They'll need to pull something out of the hat. I can't see it.
Nope. So Dundee relegated their playoff?
I think they'll get the playoff. I do. I think St Mirren will go down.
Yeah, I've just got a sneaking feeling. I keep looking at Dundee and I keep saying, God, they've had a chance here, a chance there. They've not taken the chances at the right time. Then they've lost a goal. He just needs to turn it. One win could be the saviour.
Okay. Thanks very much to Ruffy and Barry for trying to stay focused on the questions I was asking today. Do join us on Monday, where I'm sure we'll still be talking about the Old Firm game from last Sunday. Anyway, thanks for watching.
Expect the best used car deals guaranteed. Visit arnoldclark.com.